Welcome to Kababayan Today. Ako po si G. Tanji. And now we have our midweek news updates from Asian Journal.
Asian Journal, the Filipino-American community newspaper since 1991.
Joining us to give us the midweek news updates from Asian Journal is our Los Angeles correspondent, Annie Nepomuceno. Annie?
Hi! Magandang hapon sa iyo, G.
Magandang hapon.
At itong ating mga balita, after Boston Mayor Marty Walsh announced that the city is dropping its bid for the 2024 Summer Olympics, the door has opened for the U.S. Olympic Committee to name a last-minute replacement, meaning Los Angeles could have a spot. Only a few months ago, a bid proposal spearheaded by L.A. Mayor Gary Cassetti finished a close second in a four-city competition to become the next host for the 2024 Olympics. In a press conference on Monday, July 27, Boston Mayor Walsh said he could not support the city's bid, which has received low support, if that meant signing a host city contract now, as he had been asked to by the USOC. Walsh asserted that he would not commit to anything that would mortgage his city's future to fund the Olympic Games. Meanwhile, officials from the USOC and Los Angeles have repeatedly denied having any official contact, but it has been no secret that Los Angeles would be ready and willing to mount a bid on short notice. The city's proposal stressed economic efficiency with events held throughout the city, many at existing venues such as Staples Center and the renovated Poly Pavilion.
All right, and now let's go on to our second story from Asian Journal.
Yes, a federal judge ruled on Friday, July 24, that hundreds of immigrant women and children held in detention facilities in the U.S. should be released. U.S. District Judge Dolly G. said federal authorities had violated key provisions of a 1997 court settlement that put restrictions on the detention of migrant children. The federal judge found the children's imprisonment deplorable and in grave violation of the earlier settlement. The ruling is another blow to President Barack Obama's immigration policies and leaves questions about what the U.S. government will do with a large number of children and parents who crossed the border in 2014. The White House administration is detaining an estimated 1,700 parents and children at detention facilities in Texas and Pennsylvania. She gave the government until August 3 to explain why an order she plans to issue releasing the incarcerated immigrants should not be implemented within 90 days.
All right, and now let's move on to our last story from Asian Journal.
The first Filipino-American judge in the U.S., Judge Mel Recana, was first appointed to the Los Angeles Municipal Court in 1981 and later to the Los Angeles County Superior Court, and has been serving justice as one of several Filipino judges in California for well over 25 years. Well, like father, like son, on July 16, 2015, Governor Jerry Brown appointed 19 new Superior Court judges around the state and 8 in Los Angeles County. One of them is Deputy District Attorney Julian Recana, Mel's son. Julian says, "My dad was always like a coach. While every other kid played basketball and went fishing, I have childhood memories of going into this courtroom with my dad and practicing being a lawyer," he recalled.
Maraming salamat, Annie, for being here. In behalf of Asian Journal, you can check out the complete details on the website asianjournal.com. We'll be right back for more here on Kababayan Today.